Well, students, in this lecture, we are going to study about an important instrument called as the cathode ray oscilloscope, CRO. It is an instrument which is used to basically display the shape of an electrical signal. This is the only instrument rather which can display the shape of an electrical signal. Now, suppose you have a fan, okay, at home. Suppose you have a fan, ceiling fan, and you can see the two wires going into the fan. Okay, and we know that this fan, there is AC current flowing through it, through these wires. But can you see the shape of this AC signal there? Can you see it's as a sine wave or a what signal shape it is? I don't think so, right? With a multimeter or with a voltmeter, if you connect it across the wires, will you be able to see the shape of the signal? Again, the answer is no. The voltmeter will only display the value of the voltage, whether it's 220 or 240, whatever it is, but it will not show you the shape of the signal. So the CRO is the only instrument which helps you to display the shape of the signal. So how does it do it? Okay, let's study about the block diagram of the CRO and the working of it. So, this is the block diagram. We'll see each part by part separately. Now, the main component in the CRO is what is called as a cathode ray tube. Cathode ray tube, CRT. Now, what is this cathode rays or cathode ray oscilloscope, cathode ray tube? What is this cathode rays? Cathode rays are basically a beam of electrons. Initially, when electrons were discovered, they were discovered as a beam coming out of the cathode of the discharge tube. So, people at that time didn't know that they were electrons. Okay, they just said that there are some beam coming out of the cathode. So later on investigating, it was found that this beam is nothing but a beam of electrons. So today we know that cathode rays, the rays emitted from the cathode of a tube, are nothing but a beam of electrons. So this CRT, cathode ray tube, is basically an evacuated glass tube, this vacuum in it, which has some certain components inside it. The main component inside this CRT is the electron gun. The electron gun, what it does, it generates a beam of electrons. So this dotted line which you see is the beam of electrons. So it generates a beam of electrons and accelerates and focuses the beam of electrons onto the screen. So on the screen, the electron beam is focused with the help of the electron gun. So the screen has a phosphor coating on it. Okay. Now, phosphor is a material which when electrons, fast moving electrons strike it, it produces a green color dot over there. So wherever these electrons are striking the screen, you will see a green color spot in the center of the screen. Okay. Next thing. Now, how does the CRO or the CRT work? The CRO, as I told you, it displays the shape of the signal. So how does it draw the signal shape, whether it's a sine wave or a triangle wave? How does it draw it? It just works the way we draw using a pen on a paper. So the screen is like a piece of paper and the electron beam is like a pen. So if you want to draw something, you'll have to move the pen on the paper, right? Up, down, left, right, simultaneously, you have to move it. If you just keep the pen fixed in one position on the paper, you won't be getting a sine wave or any shape of any letter or anything. You'll be just getting a dot on the screen. So similar way, if you just keep the electron beam fixed at the center of the screen, all you're going to get is a dot on the screen, green color dot. So if you want to actually make this electron beam to draw a sine wave or anything, you have to move it up and down and also left and right at the same time. So left and right and up and down motions are required. So who brings about these motions? These motions are brought about with the help of these vertical plates and the horizontal plates. So there are two sets of plates. V1 and V2 are called as the vertical plates, also called the Y plates, because vertical means Y direction. And H1 and H2 are another two plates which are called as the horizontal plates or the X plates, because horizontal means X. Now what these plates do? They help in moving the electron beam on the screen up and down vertically or left and right horizontally. So the vertical plates move it up and down vertically, horizontal plates move it left and right horizontally. So how does it happen? Let's check that. So suppose let's talk about the vertical plates. So vertical plates are like this. Okay, so these are the vertical plates. So the vertical plates V1, and this is the vertical plate V2, and the electron beam can pass exactly between the plates. Okay. So this is your V1 and this is your V2, and the electron beam is passing between the plates like this. Okay, and here is the screen. So now, on the screen, what do we see on the screen? Now, wherever the electron beam strikes the screen, we see a green color dot over there. Okay, so we'll be seeing a green color dot in the center if there is no voltage applied to these plates. But suppose I apply a voltage to these plates, such that the positive is here and negative is here, what will happen? what is going through this between the plates is a beam of electrons. Electrons are negatively charged particles. So what will happen to the beam of electrons because of this? The electron beam will get deflected upwards. It will get attracted towards the positive plate. And what will happen to the spot, which was initially in the center when there was no voltage applied? When the voltage is applied now, the spot moves up. The spot moves up. From the center, it takes an upper position. How much up it will move? That depends on how much voltage you have applied. Higher the voltage you apply, more up it will move. Now next, suppose you apply the reverse the polarity of the voltage. Suppose you reverse the polarity of the voltage. What will happen? So suppose you make plus over here. This you make plus and this you make minus. What will happen? The electron beam will get deflected downwards and the spot on the screen from the center will move down. So what does the vertical plates do? Therefore, they help in moving the spot either up, vertically up when you apply plus minus, or vertically down when you make it reverse the polarity and make it plus minus this way. Okay, so the vertical plates only create vertical motion. They cannot move the spot horizontally. They can only move the spot either up and down onto the screen. Similar thing is done by the horizontal plates. What do horizontal plates will do? A similar type of job. So horizontal plates, they will so these are the horizontal plates here. So this is one plate and this is another plate, horizontal plate. So these two plates, H1 and H2. So when you apply a voltage to these plates, so let us say you apply plus over here and minus over here. What is going to happen to the electron beam which is moving between them? The electron beam which is moving between them, when you apply a voltage like this, the electron will get attracted towards a positive plate. So it will move like this towards the right side of the screen. So the spot which is in the center here, the spot will move somewhere on the right side of the screen here. Similarly, if you make this side plus and other side minus, this side you make plus and this side you make minus, then what will happen to the spot? The spot will get deflected, the electron will get deflected towards the positive plate, this side, towards the left side. So the spot will move horizontally on the screen, this side over here. Okay. So what the horizontal plates do? They move the spot either to the right side of the screen or the left side of the screen, depending upon the polarity of the applied voltage to them. So these plates here, vertical plates and horizontal plates, help in moving the spot up, down and left, right on the screen. So that's why they are called as deflection plates. Okay, next thing. Let's talk about the signal to be applied now. Now, what if, so to move the spot, to create the sine wave on the screen, you have to apply suitable types of signals to the vertical plates and the horizontal plates. What type of signals do we have to apply? Let's check that. To the vertical plates, what do we apply? To the vertical plates, if you see, if you trace back this thing, we are applying the signal to be viewed. The signal to be viewed is applied at the Y input point of the CRO. So there's something called as Y input on the CRO panel. So at this point, we apply the signal which we want to view on the screen. So suppose we on the screen, we want to view a sine wave drawn to be drawn on the screen. We apply the sine wave at the Y input. Okay, so this signal then is first amplified, the sine wave is amplified, and then you see these two lines, it goes directly to the vertical plates. So the signal which you want to view is applied to the Y input, and that signal is directly applied to the vertical plates V1 and V2. So because of this, let us say sine wave signal applied here, what do we will we see on the screen? So let's see what will we see on the screen there. Okay, so this is what happens there. So we have applied, let us say, a sine wave to the Y input. It is amplified and then goes to the vertical plates, Y plates. So this is a sine wave. It has a positive cycle and a negative cycle. Positive cycle and a negative cycle. Now during positive cycle, voltage is positive. So what will happen to the spot on the screen when you apply positive voltage? Positive means up. You remember graph phase, right? Positive Y means what? Positive vertical means what? Up. Negative Y means what? Down. So when the voltage is positive, the spot moves up. So when as the voltage goes from A to B, okay? So at A, the voltage is 0, so the spot is initially in the center. Then as the voltage increases, sine voltage increases from A to B, the signal goes up, the point goes up, and it goes maximum to point B here, corresponding to the peak value of the sine wave signal. Then from B to C, what's happening? The sine wave value is decreasing, the voltage is decreasing. So as the voltage is decreasing, the spot again comes towards the center. So it goes towards the center, so from B to C. Then at C, the voltage is 0, so at C, the spot is back in the center of the screen. Now, from C to D, the voltage is becoming negative, so the spot moves downwards. Negative means downwards, okay? And then it goes to the maximum point D corresponding to the negative peak of the sine wave of sine signal applied. And then from D to E, it's going back, the signal is going back towards 0. So the spot on the screen again goes back up. So when you apply a sine wave, what you see on the screen is a dot going up and down and back up and down like that. It keeps on continuing as long as the sine wave signal is there at the Y input point. So a sine wave signal doesn't produce a sine wave on the screen. It only produces a vertical trace. Why? Because we are applying the sine wave only to the vertical plates. For the moment right now, we have not yet applied to anything to the horizontal plates. Please remember that. Right now, we have not yet applied anything to the horizontal plates. We have only applied a sine wave signal to the Y input and then to the vertical plates through that. So because of that sine wave only applied, we only see a vertical movement of the spot. Because vertical plates can produce only vertical movement. They cannot produce any horizontal shift of the spot. So therefore, we see only see a up and down moving spot. Now, if the frequency of the sine wave is high, anything more than 25 Hertz. So 25 Hertz means what? 25 times in a second, the spot will go up and down. 25 cycles means 25 times in a second, it will happen. So 25 times in a second will go up and down. Anything more than 25, 100, 200, anything above 25, the movement, up and down movement of the spot becomes so fast that we no longer, the human eye can no longer catch the movement of the spot. All the human eye sees is a fixed vertical line on the screen. Okay, it's just like a fan, no? Fan blades. We know that there are three blades in the fan, but when they are moving very fast, we cannot see the three blades individually. We see only a disc, fixed disc. Okay, so that's a similar way. When the spot moves very fast on the screen, so when this frequency of this AC signal is high, higher than 25 Hertz, the spot moves so fast on the screen that all that we see on the screen is a vertical trace. Okay, so now from this vertical trace, can we make out the shape of the signal? So suppose instead of a sine wave, suppose we had applied a square wave, what would you have seen on the screen? So this is called a square wave. So what would happen again? You would have seen a vertical line only on the screen. Why? Because during the positive cycle, the spot would have moved up. During the negative cycle, the spot would have moved down. So again, up and down, up and down. You would have seen a vertical trace only. What about the triangle wave? If you have applied like this, this is called a triangle wave. Okay, so again, it has a positive negative cycle. So during positive cycle, the spot will move up. During negative cycle, the spot will move down. So again, up and down movement. So whether you apply sine wave, square wave, or a triangle wave, all you'll see on the screen is a vertical line. So looking at a vertical line, you cannot at all tell what type of signal you have applied. So what is missing, therefore? The horizontal movement of the spot is missing. So just by applying signal to the vertical plates will not do anything. You also have to apply some signal to the horizontal plates. So what type of signal do we need to apply to the horizontal plates to properly display a shape of the signal, whether sine wave or triangle wave or a square wave, onto the screen? So what type of signal extra is required over here? That we'll see in the next class. Okay, so right now we have talked only about the vertical, we have talked about CRT and the vertical signal to be applied. Okay, so vertical signal is always applied at the Y input. Okay, the signal to be viewed, sine wave or whatever you want to see on the screen, is always applied at the Y input. That's the important thing to remember. Okay, so we'll continue with this in the next lecture. Thank you.